Hey guys, welcome back to Maui Slime Co. Today I have yet another brand new slime shop review, and these two slime shops that you're going to see in this video are so great and amazing. So I really hope that you guys enjoy. I have another YouTube channel called Geneva Kylie DIY, so go subscribe to that. Let's just get on into the video. The first slime shop that I purchased from was from Hope's Happy Slimes. I paid $13.18 for 1 6-ounce, and it took 5 days to get here, which is a really short amount of time, which was very great. $13.18 is a little much for a underrated, but otherwise it was a pretty decent price. The slime inside the package came very well secured. It was in a bubble mailer with packing peanuts around the outside, wrapped in tissue paper, and then bubble wrap again inside. And then her little extra bag, which I love, so cute, and it was all very professional. So that was very good that she added that extra protection. Now the slime came in this really cute bag with the tissue paper inside, which I really love. And then her like extra bag with her business card and borax. I do recommend labeling the borax just in case some people might not know, but other than that, it was very professional, and I really loved that she included the slime care and warning things. It was very cute. I just really love the aesthetics of this whole package. Like I said before, make sure to label your borax in case some people who don't know will mistake it for something else, so just be careful on that. I loved how the slime was packaged. It was so adorable with the little twist tie on top, and the plastic bag was just, it was a really cute touch, and I just loved the light pink tissue paper, and everything came so nice and bubble wrapped again inside, which protected it very good. And the slime that I bought was a 6-ounce zebra cake. Now this slime did not mix at all, which I was very impressed by. Her 6-ounce container was very sturdy, nothing cracked or leaked, and it came in perfect condition. I love her little logo. It's pretty simple, but it's cute. I think that her side label is a little plain, but that's just personal preference. I do like it though. The slime was filled to the very top, which I liked a lot, and nothing mixed, which I was really impressed by. Like I said, this slime came perfect. It was perfect. I love this texture so much. I'm going like easy on this, but I'm not. It was just so good. You guys, you have to try her slimes. I don't know, I was just blown away by this texture. It was amazing. It didn't have a scent, I don't think. It didn't smell like it did. And if it did, it was a little weird. So that's the only thing that I didn't like, because the scent was kind of weird, but I don't even know if there was a scent, if I'm making any sense. But to the texture, it was just the sizzliest slime I've ever felt in like my life. It was so, so, so good. Overall, the package was so amazing. I loved it so much. The slime was just phenomenal. I have nothing bad to say about it, and it inflated a ton. The next package is from Dolphin Slime Shop, and I bought 1 8-ounce for $9.36, which is a really, really good price. And this one only took 6 days to get here, which is also really great as well. It came in a flat rate bubble mailer envelope, which was priority mail, which helped to get here a lot faster, which I really appreciated it. Now, nothing came bubble wrapped in here, which I was a little worried about, but she did use a bubble mailer, so I guess that kind of prevented it from happening. The actual slime I purchased was Oreo Blizzard, and this one came in perfect condition. It was taped on the sides, and the container was pretty sturdy. Nothing cracked or leaked, so I guess it was good. Now here's the borax. I didn't know until I read the note that that was borax. I mean, I kind of assumed, but I would still label it even if the note says. And then they sent an extra, which thank you so, so much for. Here is the note, and it explains the Borax situation. So the extra came taped up, nothing leaked or anything, and this one was so beautiful. I loved it so much. The only problem was that it was extremely overactivated. I felt really bad because I thought this was going to be a great texture, but it would have been if it wasn't overactivated. It's just too bad that it got overactivated. I really don't think it was her fault because it felt like maybe it got dried up or something. But other than that, it was really pretty and I did like it, and it was definitely the thought that counted. Moving on to the actual slime I purchased, I did want to mention that I really did like their labels. The top one was clear and it was kind of hard to see on this, but it was definitely cute. Now this one was so good because it was a little overactivated. I don't know if they just got dried up, but other than that, it was amazing. It was like the thickest slime I've ever felt in my entire life. I don't know what happened. It was probably because it was a little overactivated, but I could still stretch it. The foam beads added a really nice crunch. They sometimes fell out when I stretch it, but not all the time. So it was really great, and it was just, I really enjoyed this texture. It was amazing. It was so crunchy, and it was a really great overall texture. Overall, I really did like this slime. It was a little stiff at first, but once I kept playing with it, it just got so much better. I loved it so much. So that is all I have in today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!